What a magnum amazing day it is. I thank you for answering my prayer and giving me victory. The stone that the builders rejected has now become the cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing, and it is wonderful to see. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Please, Lord, please save us. Please, Lord, please give us success. Bless the one who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. Today is the Sabbath, 7/20/2024. And as I was doing my evening and morning devotion, what came to me was rejecting the cornerstone. Isaiah 28:16 says, "Therefore, this is what the sovereign Lord says. Look, I am placing a foundation stone in Jerusalem, a firm and tested stone. It is a precious cornerstone that is safe to build on. Whoever believes need never be shaken." The Oxford Language Dictionary defines cornerstone as an important quality or feature on which a particular thing depends or is based. Do you depend on Jesus for everything as your base, your anchor, the best quality characteristic that has stood the test of time in all situations? Or do you depend on your own thoughts and opinions? Rejecting the cornerstone of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. As this short video with love from the Lord's word is delivered, I ask that the Holy Spirit lead me along his path of righteousness and guide me, providing strength, wisdom, knowledge, truth, and the right words to say to pierce the hearts and minds of those hearing this message, and that someone will come to Jesus today for the salvation of their souls and not continue rejecting the cornerstone. 1 Peter 2:6-8 says, "As the scripture says, I am placing a cornerstone in Jerusalem, chosen for great honor, and anyone who trusts in him will never be disgraced." Yes, you will trust him. Recognize the honor God has given him. But for those who reject him, the stone that the builders rejected has now become the cornerstone. And he is the stone that makes people stumble, the rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they do not obey God's word, and so they meet the fate that was planned for them. See, people fear what they do not understand, and many people stumble over our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ because he came as the Son of God, and he flipped this world upside down. Slap me and I won't slap you back. That is not common. Do something for me and don't ask for anything back. That is not common. Think of others as better than yourself. Who is this Jesus? Matthew 23:11, Jesus said, "The greatest among you must be a servant." And Jesus came as the greatest servant among all people of all times. Jesus is so trustworthy that many people spend all of their time trying to find flaws in his perfection instead of holding on to him and modeling their lives in a similar way. See, people who refuse to believe in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ have made it the greatest mistake of their lives. Jesus is the only person who can give our life valuable meaning and purpose. But instead of those choosing Jesus, they choose self-inflicted destruction through deception, being led by the devil into sin, rejecting the cornerstone. 1 Corinthians 3:10-11 says, "Because of God's grace to me, I have laid the foundation like an expert builder. Now others are building on it. But whoever is building on this foundation must be very careful, for no one can lay any foundation other than the one we already have, Jesus Christ." See, Jesus is the cornerstone and foundation of the church. Does your church preach the good news of Jesus Christ is everything you need? Does your church preach and encourage you to follow the Ten Commandments? because you are a part of the church? Are you building your own life on the only cornerstone that counts, that will last forever? Jesus is the word of God that will never fade. Money, success, human relationships will not last. Be very careful what you build on, rejecting the cornerstone. Matthew 21, 42 through 44 says, "Then Jesus asked them, 'Didn't you ever read this in the scripture? The stone that the builders rejected has now become the cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing, and it is wonderful to see. I tell you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a nation that will produce the proper fruit. Anyone who stumbles over that stone will be broken to pieces, and it will crush anyone it falls on.'" Jesus is the truth, and when the truth is presented, it affects people in different ways. If you tell people the truth, some get defensive. Others embrace it and change their ways. When you don't accept the truth, you are rejecting it, and the truth will crush everyone that does not build their lives on it. What are you building your life on? Are you building your life on the truth of Jesus Christ, the cornerstone, or are you rejecting it? Acts 4, 11 through 12 says, "For Jesus is the one referred to in scripture where it says, 'The stone that you builders rejected has now become the cornerstone.' There is salvation in no one else. God has given no other name under heaven by which we must be saved." See, Jesus died on the cross for our sins, overcoming sin and death. Jesus is the cornerstone that connects us to God, our Father in heaven. And without Jesus as our cornerstone, we will not make it to heaven. You have many options, but only one real choice for salvation of your souls. Choose now and come to Jesus today. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus is the resurrection and the life. Jesus is the bread of life and the light of the world, the true vine, the open door, and the good shepherd of all of God's flock. Trust in God, my Savior, the one who will never fail. Your faith and obedience to Jesus determines the outcomes of your life. Stop rejecting the cornerstone and choose Jesus today. Acts 3, 19 through 20 says, "Now repent of your sins and turn to God so that your sins may be wiped away. Then times of refreshment will come from the presence of the Lord, and he will again send you Jesus, your appointed Messiah." Revelations 3, 20 through 21 says, "Look, I stand at the door and knock. If you hear my voice and open the door, I will come in and we will share a meal together as friends. Those who are victorious will sit with me on my throne, just as I was victorious and sat with my Father on his throne. May the Lord bless you and protect you. May the Lord smile on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord show you his favor and give you his peace." Amen. Thank you for taking time to watch this video. Have a magnificent day and leave a legacy doing legendary things, seeking God first in all areas of your life and making a commitment to live by the word of God. And if you are doing anything else, you are rejecting Jesus. You are rejecting the cornerstone. Our purpose is your blessing. God bless.